Same class by hinting at the statistics application. In statistics, simulation is important. Not that it's always taught, but when I teach it, I try to emphasize it. And you can simulate in Mathematica in various ways. One way is with something called a random variate. And what I'd like to show you is a little simulation with something called a normal distribution, a bell-shaped curve. Normal distribution centered at zero. That's its mean, and with something called the standard deviation of one. And we'll look at 100 simulated data values. There's 100 simulated data values from this bell-shaped distribution that, again, is centered at zero with something called the standard deviation of one. What does this mean and why is it relevant? I'm going to plot a function, and this function is the standard normal distribution, essentially. 1 over square root of 2 pi times, there's the number e, to the negative x squared over 2 power. I'm going to plot that function, which there it looks like a bell-shaped curve. I'm also going to plot the data generated by this code here, by also including something called a number line plot. Don't worry about the details of this code. So what I'm trying to put in the picture is the data, essentially, that random variate generates. There it is. And if I re-enter it again, it'll produce new data. And here's the key, two keys. The data are most dense near zero, where this density curve is highest, and a lot less dense over here and over here, where the density curve is lowest. And that doesn't matter. It's the same kind of thing happens if I do it over and over again and get different data. That principle still holds. This simulated data from this distribution is densest where this is highest. And you can make it even more precise. Areas under the curve give you approximate densities of the data. For example, it turns out that the area under this curve between negative one right there and positive one right there is about 0.68. And what that ends up meaning is the data, about 68% of the data is between negative one and one. Between negative two and two, the area under the curve is about 0.95, which means about 95% of the data is between negative two and two. There's 100 data points here. About 5 of them should be either less than negative two or greater than positive two. How many? 1 right there. 2, 3, 4, 5. I can't tell if that one's bigger than 2 or not. 95% is between negative 2 and 2, meaning 5% is less than negative 2 or bigger than positive 2. Areas under the curve gives you those percentages. Areas, integrals. Numerical integration is also necessary because you can't integrate this function symbolically without introducing a new function called the ERF function. ERF. Sound like a dog there. ERF, ERF. Error function. It's a new function. You've never heard of it before. Why do they call it the error function? Because it's related to errors in experiments. That's why. It's also related to improper integrals. Because the integral of this function from minus infinity to plus infinity turns out to equal 1. Proving that, though, is quite a challenge. All right, see you Wednesday.